We're back, and part of the recent Volunteers Week that occurred, we have with us as a guest Sarah Gilmore, and you are the communicator. Is that correct? Is that the word?
Communications coordinator.
The communications coordinator for AIMS, which is...
Oh, you answer the telephone.
Constantly. AIMS is a program that specifically is for supporting migrants and refugees that come to Australia.
Yep, AIMS is the organisation, yep.
Okay, so give us just a rundown of, you have 2,000 volunteers.
Over 2,000 volunteers, that's
right. Are you in charge of all the 2,000?
No, I'm not personally.
Okay. Most of these volunteers.
Spread the workload.
Yes, well there's several areas of our business, but mostly they're all dedicated to helping newly arrived refugees and migrants come to Australia, set them up with their support services and help them integrate into the wider community. Settle, learn English, find work, you know, send their, see their kids off to school, right. Have families, buy a house, you know.
Right, so yeah. These volunteers, are between the ages of 18 and 80, really.
That's right.
So it covers a large span of age group. And most of these people do speak many languages.
That's right, yep.
So they're able to interact with them and help them in most ways.
Yeah, what we're finding is... the profile of our volunteers is starting to change. Previously, our core need for volunteers was to help teach English to the newly arrived people. But what we're finding more and more is the newly arrived people that have come through the program are coming back to volunteer and help the new people.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, because they've been through the experience, they understand the barriers and the issues involved, so they come back to help out.
So a returning cycle.
Yeah, nice. Exactly. It is good. And, you know, a little bit of first language helps our clients learn English as well.
Yeah.
How long has it been going, the program?
AIMS has been in operation for nearly 60 years. It started after the Second World War when we had the first wave of big wave of migration.
And that would have been primarily European migration.
That's right. And we've watched every single wave since then come through, and obviously every community coming through has different needs, different support required.
How hard then is it to match up? Because obviously, you know, if all of a sudden you get a wave of people coming from Somalia and Africa and things like that, how hard is it to then find volunteers or people to work in that? You know, the catch-up.
Well, in the first instance, it's quite likely and possible that they will be matched with volunteers that have been doing it for some time and are comfortable. That's what our volunteers essentially do. They're contributing to an inclusive society. So they're saying, you know what, you guys are from the other side of the world and you're here and you're going to be staying here, and so we want to help you learn English and integrate. So. And that's what we won the Achievement Award for, because that's what our volunteers, they do. They contribute to an inclusive society. So basically the people that come to volunteer for us are already saying, you know, I see the value in you being here and I want to learn about your community and I want to learn about your cultural differences. And so that's how it starts. But as the communities mature and some of the Somalis, you're saying, for example, learn English, settle, go through the stages of settlement that there are, they come back to help.
Do you find that, you know, the danger of when people come to a country, and as Simon was saying before, they end up in so-called ghettos, you know, whatever, because it's comfortable. No, what I mean is their own community, which means when they come, they need to be with people that speak the same language as them to start with and can support them as well. And after that, they might integrate with Australians. Do you find that Australians are really receptive? Do you think they're a bit racist against any of them? Or how does that work from the Australian point of view, accepting the migrant?
Well, as I just pointed out, we have over 2,000 volunteers.
But I mean the greater community, not the volunteers that help them. But let's say in the community, do you find the Australians...
Well, I just find if over 2,000 people in Melbourne are willing to volunteer and come forward, and yes.
That's reflective of the...
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. You know, and there's always going to be barriers and issues surrounding multiculturalism. There is everywhere in the world. Yeah. But as for the most part, Australians are great and they do their bit, just like our volunteers are doing their bit.
Do you help them, do the volunteers help the clients find jobs or where to turn to for these?
That's another part of our program is finding work and vocational training. So our volunteers will help with vocational skills. So we have what are called social enterprises. So the volunteers go into the kitchens, a lot of them are catering, and help assist with teaching them how about food hygiene, how to cook, you know, how kitchen works, so on and so forth. And in terms of finding work, we have job clubs. So people that have experience, like all of us have experience in the Australian workplace culture and how job search happens, because it's different, over here than it is from where they come from.
And sport, is there any?
Sport's massive.
Massive?
Absolutely massive.
So any AFL scouts looking around?
Soccer.
This is the soccer. New would be the...
soccer, absolutely. Not football, you'd have to teach them AFL.
Well, soccer's getting there, but AFL do a lot of work with multicultural communities and we work with them. And yeah, there's always volunteers. Soccer, music, sport, music, food, you know, all those areas where culture can overact and interact, that's where it all happens. So that's what we're trying to do with our volunteers. We're trying to say, right, well, okay, you can't teach English for 2 hours a week, but what can you do?
Yeah. So we're trying to get into people with passion and different skills available.
It's tremendous work that you guys are doing.
You should be doing something.
I volunteer.
What do you do that's altruistic?
I
volunteer for the shtick. That's what we all do. We're all volunteers, aren't we?
That's right.
You mean you're not getting paid?
I insist I'm not getting paid.
I give blood.
Yeah, and ribs.
Through your teeth.
We'd like to thank you for coming, Sarah.
Thanks for having me.
We wish you all the best and for the AIMS program. Well, I think it's a very worthy thing in these times. And
always.
Do you have motorboats that go out to the boat people?
To pick them up.
Early training.
They only go to the airport.
No, okay.
No. They pick them up from the airport.
And they're not volunteers, they're trained staff. So.
Terrific. Okay, well, thanks again for coming.
Thanks. I'd just like to say thanks to all our volunteers, if any of them watch.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, we thank them also. Fantastic.
And we'll be back